Hey, what's up everyone? So in this video I'll be showing you how to use Sidecar and how to set it up. So basically Sidecar is the macOS kind of native version of using your iPad as a secondary display. There have been third-party apps in the past that have done this, but Apple's taking it on by themselves, and now they're building it into macOS Catalina as well as iOS 13. So first things first, make sure your Mac is using or running macOS Catalina and your iPad is on iOS 13. Or newer. So not every Mac and iPad are supported, but the ones that are, see right here, this is from 9to5 Mac, so the iPad 6, 7th generation, the iPad Mini 5, the iPad Air 3rd generation, and all iPad Pros. And then for the Mac side, you have the iMac 27-inch late 2015 or newer, MacBook Pro 2016 or newer, Mac Mini 2018, Mac Pro 2019, MacBook Air 2018 or newer, MacBook Early 2016 or newer, and iMac Pro 2017 or newer. If your device is on that list, you should be good to go. If it's not, then you're kind of out of luck. You're going to have to go with a third-party app in order to get this done. So let's go ahead and get started, and I'll show you how to do this. So the Mac is on macOS Catalina, and my iPad is running iOS 13. So first thing, you have to go into System Preferences on your Mac. And as you can see, there's a new option here for Sidecar, so go ahead and choose that. And here's the Sidecar options or settings. There's not that much. You can choose where you want the sidebar, where you want the touch bar, and whether you want to have double tap using an Apple Pencil enabled. I don't have an Apple Pencil, so unfortunately I can't use any of those features, but next thing is just connect to the iPad. So this connect to was grayed out for me for about 20 to 30 seconds when I first did this. So if your iPad's not showing up and everything's compatible, you know, just wait 20 to 30 seconds and hopefully it should show up. If you're still having issues, make sure your Wi-Fi is turned on. It doesn't have to be like disconnected from any Wi-Fi network, just make sure Wi-Fi is on. So once you make sure that Wi-Fi is on, you shouldn't have too many issues connecting. So we'll go and choose Peyton's iPad. So you can see the screen refreshes, and my iPad goes straight to the secondary display. So let's see what kind of options we have here. Let's go back to System Preferences, and we'll go to the displays. All right, so we can choose the arrangement. So I'm gonna put it right in the bottom right corner because that's kind of how I have it set up. And as you can see, AirPlay display, it is using Peyton's iPad, so that's good. And then you do have some options. So if you move over to the iPad, not really many options. You use default for display or scaled. They're both the same. It's going to be 1048 by 770, and that is all you have to choose. So if you want any other resolution, you're kind of out of luck. One thing that is just blows my mind is how smooth this is. Like really, it's probably at least 30 frames per second, which is very impressive. So you might be wondering now, so can I use the touch screen on the iPad? Can I use the pencil? The Apple Pencil does work, but it does not work as a touch screen. So you cannot just poke it and use that as a touch screen. But if you do have an Apple Pencil, you can use that. As far as I know, you can use the Apple Pencil basically like your finger to touch anything. It doesn't necessarily have to be like a drawing app or anything, just using the Apple Pencil, anything you can touch, which is pretty cool. Unfortunately, regular, you know, finger touch screen support is not included, so that's kind of a bummer, but I mean, generally speaking, it is a very cool feature because just how smooth it is and just how seamless it is to transition. So there's also, if we go to the macOS side, up in the upper right corner, you do have quick shortcut options to connect and disconnect to your device. So as you can see, connected to Peyton's iPad shows up right here. If you don't have this menu up here, just go and open Display Preferences and check this little box right at the bottom to show mirroring options in the menu bar when available. That'll make sure that you have that option in the upper right corner at all times. So if you want to just quickly connect, you don't have to go into System Preferences to do so, which is very handy. And so that's basically it. That is Sidecar using macOS Catalina and iOS 13. If you guys have any questions, go and leave them in the comments section down below. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.